All right, tell us about the Flash. 24 packs, one memorabilia card, one wardrobe card, I know. Other than that, I need some assistance.
Well, there's going to be 5 cards per pack, so this isn't a super, super packed pack. So we should get through this somewhat quickly. Very crazy, though. Like I said, the first 17 signers have been announced. I wonder if there's any secret signers that have not been announced yet. We'll find out if we hit one. The chase sets include character bios, metas, and quotable Cisco.
In fact,
you as a Flash viewer may...
Here's one right here.
Understand that.
I think you're just mad because my conditioner game is on point.
Mad?
His hair.
Oh, okay. I thought you were talking to me directly. I realize what's going on. And I'm also hearing from the chat that at conventions,
Parallel.
Gustin charges over $200 an auto. So he is... Scarce everywhere. Amy Hood pitching in with, he's hard to see at conventions too, thanks to scheduling. And Jordan added an eye roll as to why he charges so much. I love it. Very cool. And also, how cool is that Jordan and Amy, they're in chat almost every single week. They came in originally for Cryptozoic, and they stick around. Really love both of your inputs. So much fun to have some Cryptozoic experts in here giving us some insight on the fan world and then also sticking around for sports. And I did see also Pam Keller popped into Facebook a little bit ago. Pam, we hope that you're doing well and glad that you're still able to continue watching the show. So, Rob, we're going to hit a wardrobe card. We're going to hit an autograph or a prop card. We don't know if the prop cards are one in every box, though that was TBD.
The parallel
the others
game
are
been
each one per box.
In this product. Look at that.
Yeah. Well, remember, we talked about that. I feel like it was the last one we saw from them where we really saw that for the first time. And I loved it. Was that... which one did we do last? Oh, my gosh.
Gotham.
Was it Gotham Season 2?
Believe so.
Yeah.
Boom! We got a not a Gustafson, but a great auto. Chantel Van Zanten. She's in several of her TV shows, including she plays Ryan Phillips' wife on the USA show Shooter, adapted from the movie. Big name. She played Patty Spivot, Barry Allen's girlfriend. Awesome. Nice.
You know what's really funny about that is I specifically remember you mentioning her when we went over Hot in the Shop last week and saying how excited you were for her being in it.
Yep, how about that? That's awesome.
Because of her experience on multiple shows that you were a fan of.
Yep.
So that was very cool.
If I couldn't get a grant, that would be one that I would want. But I can't have it. Somebody else
also
gets
props
it.
To... Marlon at Sparty Hawk Cash just did one of the coolest tweets I've seen. He is actually ripping Topps blasters while watching Steve, and he tagged Honus Bonus and shared the Collector's Universe symbol. That's very cool. Something else I didn't get to mention when Steve was on the product.
Wait, you know, our Dr. Wells may have been evil, but you're just a dick. Quotable Cisco.
You're telling me I should watch this show. That's what I'm hearing.
Go ahead. You were saying another great parallel.
Oh no, we can get to that a little bit later.
The
chat room is going off on that card. I know that we'll be posting it on Twitter in just a minute for you to enter to win. Is anyone in the chat room not on Twitter?
Different type of parallel.
I'm curious about that.
Look at that.
We also just hit 50 in Facebook.
See this? There's this little red flash guy down here. It's a different type of parallel.
Is it?
Cool. I don't remember that announced.
Yeah. Wow. Almost like the, was that the only one that you've seen of that so far?
So far, yeah.
Yeah, because that doesn't have it on there.
Be cool.
That doesn't have... Ooh, is that a shark?
Yes, that is a shark.
Love it. How cool are sharks?
Sharks are cool. Except if they're on Sharknado. Then they're
I don't know. I think
lame.
They're still pretty cool. I think it's just the actors on Sharknado that are lame. I think the sharks themselves are still pretty cool.
Oh, come on. Ian Ziering is cool, isn't he?
Rob, Ian Ziering wasn't even cool when Ian Ziering was cool.
Right?
You know that.
He did marry Nikki.
I live in 90210, and he is not.
And Nikki Ziering took his name, so he's doing something right for Benchwarmer.
Oh, hey, I see the tweet is up and already in the double digits, so make sure you go to GoGTS Live on Twitter, twitter.com/GoGTS Live. Retweet the pinned tweet. That's how you enter to win the, oh, let me get her name right.
Patty Shawn, yes. Chantel Van
Santen.
I almost said Patty Spivitt. That was her character.
Yeah. Oh, Eric wants me in a Sharknado movie. Please tweet the Asylum and tell them. Tell them to put me in a Sharknado movie. That would be awesome.
I would watch that one.
Tag Cryptozoic or Rittenhouse or whoever does Sharknado. Oh, by the way, Rob, well, should I publish this? I actually know of a brand. There is a brand out there. There is a franchise that is not represented in the card space that I feel is ready for it.
What is that?
I don't know if somebody has the license or not. What do you think about that? Who should get the license on a brand that is not yet known that would have that type of large enough following at this point? Who should get the license on that?
Cryptozoic or Rittenhouse, right?
Who should I share this with? I don't know. I mean, there's others that have, you know, that do that. Upper Deck and Tops both have entertainment divisions. You know, I don't know. Who should we play favorites with?
We don't. That's right.
Rob, there's lots of love for Sharknado going on in the.
I watched the first one. It was enjoyable from, you know, that campy B-type movie. There she is. Katie Cassidy is the Black Siren.
James Gale, the asset, is telling us right now that he wants Twin Peaks, a Cryptozoic Twin Peaks set. We'll have to see. Did anybody watch the new one that was this week, or is that this next week on Showtime? Did anyone watch that? Anyone?
That show was hot in its heyday, wasn't it?
Well, interesting enough,
there's another one of those little flashy guys.
That's right. We'll have to, someone tweet George and ask him about those. Take a picture of that.
Oops. I'm back. Yes. Ooh, look at that. Nice. Two great hits from this box. Candace Patton as Iris West. Look at that multicolor authentic wardrobe swatch, which matches the blouse she's wearing in the picture. Fantastic. Let me get a better shot of that for you.
It does, except that it's right on top of the
blouse. Yeah, you can see it, though, if you...
Well, I gotta be fair, Rob, because we give Cryptozoic so much love. If I see something slightly wrong, I do have to point it out, just for the sake of... It's the first time in a while I've been able to point something out on there. Fair enough?
Fair enough.
Get with it, George. You had one bad photo placement in the fifth set that we've opened from you. Which, another very interesting thing about Cryptozoic, allegedly... Rumor has it that they very purposefully make sure that every box will have a complete base set.
Yeah, I like that.
Whoa, was that a monkey?
No, that was a gorilla. That was Grodd.
Gorillas are monkeys.
The telepathic gorilla.
Now, I never watched Smallville. I would love to someday have the time to catch up.
I didn't either, and I agree with you.
From what I gathered, though, one of the things with Smallville was that they made everything very realistic. While I just saw a shark and a gorilla, and they looked pretty awesome, and that's actually what I want in my superhero things. I love the sharks. I love the gorillas. Also, Juggernaut hasn't been done right on state on screen yet. That's a whole nother discussion, though.
Frost. Another cool parallel.
So yes, I guess I did just sort of personify some of the collectors that I complain about. You know, hey, what if wouldn't it be great if the patch matched the picture on the card? Oh, well, you did that. Well, guess what now? Now that you did that, because they always strive to do that with Cryptozoic, which is so much fun.
Last pack.
We've also heard Timothy Sill mentioned that an American Ninja Warriors set would be cool. I agree.
Yeah, that's been taught. Somebody was...
Absolutely awesome.
Special last pack mojo!
What?
Eddie Thorn Star Power card. Ooh. These are rare. Like, rarer than one per case.
Wow, really? I don't even see them on the sell sheet here.
Yep. Surprise, surprise. They were a surprise. It first debuted in Gotham, and they put them in here, too. In all honesty, this... I'm watching this. This isn't even doing it justice. You got to see these in hand. We definitely want to get this in the hands of a lucky collector. It is a big boom.
How do you spell star power on that?
STRPWR.
I want to try and see what they're like.
Yeah, people are just now beginning to get educated about them. I don't think people still realize how rare they are, but I'm privy to these marketing calls with Cryptozoic, and I can tell you, they're rare.
Wow, that's really awesome.